Hello everybody, welcome to the Magic Bricks Dialogue Series. We are at the Fortune City, Hiranandani Fortune City at Panvel, and I've got Mr. Niranjan Hiranandani here with me. What a pleasure to have you with us again.
My pleasure too. Thank you.
So we're talking about a city that is outside in the peripheral areas, that is in the early stages of development. We are talking about Panvel, where there is probably a container freight station nearby, a college nearby, there is an industrial area nearby, and the potential of future growth with a lot of commercial area coming up. Help us understand who should be buying into Panvel today.
Let me go back a little bit in history. If you look at any of the projects which Hiranandani chooses, it's going to be in the next 5 years the center of gravity of the city growth that we project to have. My gut feel, my study, our vision and directions indicate also that Panvel will be the center of gravity of the growth of Mumbai in the next 5 years. Now, it's obvious to everybody. When we actually started it, everybody questioned me as to what is going to happen. Today, there is nothing that doesn't lead to Panvel. And I'm talking not only Fortune City, but the entire Panvel center of gravity has changed. You have the Cross Harbour Bridge work starting from January. You have the Sion Panvel Freeway, which is already a connection of a 10-lane plus freeway right from Sion to Panvel, already complete in all respects. So no flyovers between Sion and Panvel. We have the Panvel-Karjat railway line with passenger traffic, which will be starting, and we'll have a railway station across the road.
When will that become?
It's starting. The work is starting immediately, and in 2 years' time, we are expecting this to happen. You have the Navi Mumbai Airport. The work has already started. All this put together with the Cross Harbour Bridge coming in, which means half an hour from South Mumbai that you will be able to reach Panvel in 5-6 years' time. I don't believe that there is any other location as far as the Mumbai peripheral is concerned which will be as hot and ready as Panvel. So, as far as the location is concerned, I think it's not so difficult to sell the idea of what we are going to do. It was far more difficult in Powai and Thane when we got over there. So I don't see that as an issue at all. So what is the growth centers of Mumbai? The growth centers can either be western side or it can be central side. Our gut feel has been that the central side, which is going towards Pune, is far more richer in terms of area, in terms of infrastructure and the development that we do. We have everything over here. The Ambani Hospital is next door. We have at least a dozen schools and colleges already operating, and we plan to, of course, set up our own school. All the other amenities in townships, which you see in Powai, which you see in Thane, you're going to get also in Panvel. So, as far as a township is concerned, we are committed to make one of the best that we have ever made before to replicate as far as Panvel is concerned. That's what Panvel is all about.
So who would be living here? What is the profile of the people who are going to live here, say, 5 years from now?
My reading is personally that 75% of the people always in the initial stages come in from outside. So they come and stay over here because the quality of life and the affordability is much better, and still they are able to link up to go to everywhere else. Over a period of time, what changes is it becomes the reverse. 75% will be the people who will work here and live in this area. So whether they are professionals, whether they are people doing service, whether there is people who will work in the area. So as the business in the area picks up, it will become reverse. The same has happened in all our other townships. So earlier you'll get an investor investing from all over the world, whether in Mumbai or from abroad, wanting to buy apartments and stuff like that, and then maybe give it out on lease and stuff and get the appreciation of value, which always happens. And then afterwards, people get confident who want to be able to live themselves and stay. Fortunately, today, I think it's already improved in the sense that more than 25 to 30% are the people who locally want to work and live over here. So that's already started.
Where do they stay today?
Today, they may be staying in Navi Mumbai, they may be staying in the center of town, or they may be even NRIs from abroad. So they are all investors people. Some of the NRIs also want to retire over here. So they're living now in Dubai, they're in Qatar, they're in Singapore, and they want to buy an apartment and be committed to the future of what Hiranandani promises to give.
Sir, a lot of people have been asking us, what is the advantage of living in a township over living in a standalone?
Oh, that's the easiest sale. Today what happens is that if you have a standalone house, you really don't get a quality of life that you need. With the congestion of Mumbai being what it is, anywhere that you want to go, travel time is quite a pain. Happens even at 7 in the morning. That's an issue which we really have to face until the metro really completes it. But when you live in a township, the way you live and the quality of life is so wonderful that even if you're coming from outside, the moment you enter there and back home, you're in heaven. You get gardens, you get schools, you get all the quality of life, you get retail, you get entertainment, and the entire works comes within the city or in the neighborhood. I mean, it's not always necessary into the city, but the townships usually draw a lot of magnet in altars. For example, if you look at Powai, you have 25 fine restaurants today. You have 30 banks working from there. You have 150 corporates working there. You have 70,000 people working over there. Now, obviously, when you have that kind of population already working there, living there in the neighborhood, but it's not everybody who works there lives there. But the quality of life of working, the quality of life of people living there is par excellence.
So let's pick up Panvel now. How will Panvel, you said Panvel will be far more than what Powai and Thane are. Let's go deeper into the Panvel story. What are the USPs that you think?
See, first of all, you have to understand that when we started Powai and Thane, we built the commercial much later. Today, we have 2 million square feet of commercial already built and ready for the purposes of marketing. That particular part will bring in at least 20,000 people who will be working over here. Now, if 20,000 people start to work in Panvel Township itself, this itself completely changes the environment, the eco-environment of the location completely changes. So people will rent out the premises, they will be shopping over there, they'll send their children to school over there, there'll be a hospital nearby, there'll be gardens, walking tracks, there'll be a forest next door. All this put together, plus commute time in terms of the railway station coming up, the availability of connectivity either to Pune side or to the city side or the new international airport or the cross harbour bridge to go straight to South Mumbai. So if you want to work over here, the quality of life will be great. If you want to live over here, the quality of life will be wonderful. If you want to commute from here, it's easy connectivity to everything that you can possibly get. And if you want to travel anywhere, the railway stations will be available. The connectivity, both in terms of the sea connectivity, and of course the international corridors are all ending over here. The Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor, the travel corridor, the corridors to Pune, and of course connectivity to Pune if you want to go up there. It's all available.
So which are the first industries that you expect to move here?
Well, we think that this is going to be the commercial and IT hub expansion that will take place. So people who will move their offices for purposes of consolidation will come over here very soon. So you're going to get companies which will put up their corporate offices, which will come over here, similar to what has happened in the case of Powai and Thane. So we have a large number of corporate offices coming. We think that the IT centers will also expand into this location. And of course, there's a cost benefit ratio in the sense that we are selling over here at half the price of Thane and maybe one fourth of the price in the case of Powai. So from a cost point of view, your investment is much lower. And obviously the quality of life is as good and much better in so many respects. So what is really happening is, It's about being able to foresee the future and to understand that, look, here is something which is going to be fantastic for the future. It'll be a newer place. It'll be newer built. All the facilities will be brand new, sparkling new, polishing and shiny. And the mistakes that you make in the older townships, you rectify. The sizes of the roads, the other amenities that we have given, where people have expected. We couldn't vision it 30 years ago. We now put it in Panvel.
So let's talk about the kind of apartments you have. What are the sizes that you...
So we have all the sizes. We have the one bedroom, two bedrooms, three bedrooms, and of course we will have the luxury penthouses also. So we give the gamut of the things because we do believe that there's going to be a range. It's a township. It's not something which is for a particular niche. So we make all of them. We make the one bedroom right up to three and even four.
What is the demand currently?
Oh, we have already sold out 1,200 apartments in the first sector, which is Sector A, which is already built up. The buildings are already up. You can see it from the highway. And we are in the position, I think, in another 18 to 24 months, all these buildings will be occupied. Two buildings, of course, are already occupied by customers, and they're already living over here. So that's the first part of it. The second part of it will be 1,200 apartments, and the third will be another 11 to 1,200 apartments. So in another 3 to 4 years, you'll have only 2,500 apartments occupied.
Right. When you're in a township and there is development continually happening, how do you ensure that the ones who move in first are not hassled by the development that goes on?
We have had lots of past experiences, and we've learned our lessons of being able to contain these noises and to see that the kind of negative effect is minimal. So we do get complaints. I cannot be dishonest about it, and people do feel unhappy that there is even iota of construction taking place. So that's a bit of a negative, yes, but the quality of negativism is so minimal that you really don't feel it so much. So, and what we are trying to do is to do sector-wise. So all the buildings in a sector we put up together. So when the sector is complete, you are insulated. So that's kind of, remember one thing, these sectors itself are so, the property incidentally is 580 acres. Which is only, Powai is 250 acres, Thane is 350 acres, there's 580 acres. So when you make a certain sector, whether it's 10 acres or 15 acres, for other developers, it's like a complete project. So when I finish these 10 buildings or 8 buildings, which we do of a sector, it's almost like townships of other developers being completed. So that sector gets completed, so there is minimal disturbance to that sector because the rest of the sectors is a little away from the present sectors that we have. But I can't deny it that it cannot be completely noise-free or dust-free completely. But we've had this for the last 30 years in Powai, last 20 years plus in Thane, and we've really not had too much of a problem. But yes, some complaints definitely.
Tell me about Hiranandani communities. I think what you're trying to do is create a community where you live. Tell us something more about it.
We realized one thing, that if we made just buildings, that was just a small part of what life is. We realized that beyond that, it was the community which was very, very, very important. And it's the people that really have to be the center focus. So if you don't look after the children, you don't understand safety, security, if you don't have the proper schooling, if you don't have the proper neighbor side of shopping areas, if you don't have the proper commute possibility, and we don't look after the community's entertainment in terms of what we do, we try to see that all parts of what community needs to be happy. And that's why the happiness part of it is now a center focus of what Hiranandani communities wants to have for each of the persons who live with us, work with us, commute with us, participate in life with us. So we consider that an extended family. We don't consider either our stakeholders, who are our contractors, suppliers, or anybody, or our consumers, to be outside this habit. We want to extend happiness to all of them. And that's the focus of why we say it's Hiranandani communities now, not just the construction part of it. I'm not undermining the quality of construction, because that's extremely important. But ultimately, the center focus now has to be more the consumer and the customer, and see to it what is his needs and how can I make him more happy.
And does the community take the initiative as well, or is it something that you have to drive?
No, we only ignite, we start, we facilitate, we act as catalysts. We never take over the entire role. But we see to it that we are facilitators in every respect. So whether it's a customer who comes in the beginning for the purposes of looking for an apartment, to see that what is that person's need and how can we fulfill that need, to a person who says, I don't need my apartment today and I want to rent it out. So we will help that person. The person wants a mortgage. We will help that person. So these are the fiscal attachments to a sale of an apartment. But we then look after the rest of it. We help them to form the societies. We help them afterwards when they have problems with their homes and houses. We look after their needs if there are problems in the initial stages for buildings, and sometimes for 10 years we look after it. And so on and so forth. Then all the entertainment that really takes place around the complexes. I remember first trying to ignite a Navratri festival dance in Powai. And for 2 years, 3 years, I really had to get people to come there. Today, it's a bustling thing and they've almost forgotten to even invite me. But that's the fun of it all. And we run the marathons, both in the half marathons in Powai and in Thane. So what we really do is to ignite all these facilities for communities. But we really don't do it. We find that the community takes over a lot of this activity. The festivals are all celebrated, whether it's the Bengali festival, whether it's the Govinda festival, various communities come together and do it. But our idea is to have a holistic thing. The quality and respect of every individual. It's not a sectoral thinking that we have, we've never had. And we do believe that this has helped to create a Mumbai-centric, unique community.
Right. So you're very conscious about the green, right? In terms of recycling, rainwater harvesting and so on. Just briefly take us through your green initiatives.
Well, when we took over Powai, we had only 20 trees. We have today 4 lakh trees, which are more than 40 feet tall. So we are not talking about bushes and plants and millions and all. Similarly, in Thane, we did that greening, and we are also now doing it in Panvel. But every center that we do, we see that there is adequate amount. We have even adopted forests in this area. So we do that in afforestation. Incidentally, we have also afforested the hill in Vikroli. A 25-acre hill belonging to the revenue department is afforested by us. Unfortunately, leopards also come sometimes there. We are now on the other part of it. We have been recycling water in Powai and Thane for the last 20 years plus. So we recycle, reuse all the water, and that's helpful in order to see to it that we don't send out dirty water at all, except during the monsoon. But even then, it's treated and then sent out. And the third part of it is that we see to it that the buildings are green buildings. They are all certified green buildings. We have platinum rated buildings, which are commercial, and the other buildings are also green buildings under the certification. So we've always been energy conscious. We have been environmentally friendly. We have looked at plantations and other things. And we have not done it now. We've done it for the last 25 years. So we continue to enhance that and grow this segment completely. And it's so much fun.
It is. You are in the foothills of the Western Ghats. A lot of runoff will be coming here. Is water an issue here?
No, really not. So we have adequate amount of water over here, and availability of water is plenty. So we are really fortunate, as you said correctly, that being at the foothills over there, there's a lot of draw water availability, and we don't see any problem whatsoever to do it.
So do you have any water bodies within your
township? There are some small water bodies within, but we have a lot of water sources from which we are able to draw water. There's no problem whatsoever. And of course, we will be recycling the water to see that there's no wastage.
One final concern that consumers have raised, a newly developing township, will security ever be a concern?
I don't think so at all. The security that you will have, in fact, is very enhanced. Secondly, we do believe that when we create the township model, there is an entrance barrier which acts as the second security, perimetry security, as you do. As you know, the Prime Minister has three security barriers. We have two. So the buildings will have security, one, and then you have a second at the gate entry of the periphery of the township. So we are kind of dual secured, and now with all the communications availability, everything has got CCTV on the roads as well as in the buildings. So the security is pretty enhanced. Of course, if somebody wants to commit a crime, there is no way really can do it. But the deterrent over here is huge. So if there is any place which could be safe, it will be our townships.
And coming from the city to your township, is that also a safe?
Oh, it's fantastic. I mean, today, all the roads that we came by, and you must have come by, are all fully secured roads, and they're very well managed and all that. Very wide roads, expressway and freeways and all that. So no problem at all.
So managing an over 500-acre township is like running a city, right? Do you have your own policing mechanisms, your fire departments? How do you manage such a large town?
See, we do, we have to remember one thing. We cannot substitute for police because we don't have the legal powers to do so. But we have our own internal security systems. This has worked extremely well in Powai and Thane. And we expect to replicate that in Panvel at the Hiranandani Fortune City. So we think that that is adequate for us to do. We've not had any problems whatsoever. As far as the commercial sides are concerned, the buildings are absolutely further secured. So they have additional security at the perimetry as far as that is concerned. But it's a very safer city. But again, as people said, can somebody commit a crime over there? Sometimes we find people commit crime within, but because we have the systems of monitoring, we've been able to catch a lot of people as far as that is concerned.
So technology is a big enabler today, whether it is in home automation, in managing the township, even in construction technologies. Where all does Hiranandani rely on technology?
Well, that's a long story, but let me put it this way. We use the best technology in the world. So whatever we do, whether it's in construction, quality of materials, speed, methodology, we use it all. As far as the ERP and other systems, we also use the best in the world. We have the best consultants. We have international consultants who come and advise us on the matter. We have lovely architects within the company and also from the environment that we have in India. So we have the best technology, we have the best consultants, and obviously from our experience within the organization, we have learnt it a lot. So some things are really indigenously improved. Many of the speeds of construction of our latest building are probably amongst the fastest in the entire world. So we just completed a building for TCS in Thane, and we completed 2 million square feet, 16 stories in a matter of 18 months.
What helped you do that?
Oh, it was project management, which was the center of it, good contractors. We used the best technology in the world. And the speed was just because there was fantastic coordination between all the people together.
So we're in an era of smart cities, where existing cities want to smarten themselves up. You're creating a new city. So what are those smart features? And one of the things that they say will make cities smart is the meticulous planning of all services into master plans so that you could...
So this is the first time that we are putting in everything that we have put in Powai and Thane. So I'm not going to go through the nitty-gritties, which is, ducted services that we do, communication network that we have, mobile connectivities, etc., and all the internet and other thing is taken for granted. But what we try to do is that we are now trying to even facilitate to provide different sort of things together. So we may even produce electricity, which will be at lower rates for customers that ultimately will happen. We'll provide an end use center amount of billing, which will take place for all these services by a separate services company that we need to create. So we want to enhance those activities to the next level. And the third is, which is of course going to be a part of the Start City, is we're going to integrate all these things, which is the security network, with the availability of telephone and other communications, so that all the facilities can now be on an app which you will be able to utilize what it is. So any of these things, whether it's security, whether it's availability of electricity or the connectivity to different mobile persons and the signals and whatever it is, should be the best. So all that will be fibered right up to the home.
So the citizen can just carry the
cell phone and
do a lot of this activity, and also that the internet and other facilities direct to home is going to be extremely high, which today as a feature would not have been available to other townships. But we are preempting that. We're trying to think what's going to happen 2 years from today.
So to end this conversation, what would you say is the Hiranandani Panvel lifestyle that people should aspire for?
Well, there are two short things that I would like to say. The first is that when people bought in Pawai, they said 1,000 rupees a foot. You want me to buy a flat? You must be crazy. Today, all the people who didn't buy at that time, this crazy place, are reselling it at 30,000 rupees a foot in a building called Lake Castle. More than 30,000 rupees a foot. Similar, in Thane, we started at 1,300 rupees a foot, as far as this is concerned. The price is only 10 times more in the same buildings. So that's a huge change. So today we are starting at 6,000 rupees a foot, and this is also going to grow tremendously in the next couple of years. So if you are smart and you're clever enough to be an early investor into this township, whether you want to come and stay, or you want to live over here, or you want to work in this area, or you want to be a plain investor into the real estate segment, this would be a place for you, because this is what I am betting on. And we are putting a lot of money into this project and our commitment to say that this is going to be our next great project. So if you believe in us, we hope that you do, and join us in this particular Hiranandani Fortune City, where we see great future and, of course, a great fortune for you.
So it's not just a house that you're buying. It's a lifestyle. It's a community. It's a way of life. And if that's what you're looking for, you get it at rates that are probably 10 times more in another 5 years. Thank you for joining us.